right, welcome. We are here and we're doing the second part of section two. It's actually number 13 in the book, so it's where we're doing some journal entries. And so we're going to do some entries for a liability loan, and we're going to do some entries for some equity, right? Some owner investment. And so we're going to go ahead and do that. So in order to do journal entries in QuickBooks, we're going to go up to the little plus new, right, on the top left there. And in the other column, there's journal entry there. So we're going to go ahead and select that. Okay. So these journal entries are going to have, we're going to have to do the dates. So just go ahead and follow the dates that are in the textbook. So we're going to do this out into the future is what we're going to do with these. So we're going to do these into the future. And so this one will be, for example, I'm going to do January 1st, 2025 is what we're going to do. And so maybe someday, of course, this video, January 1st, 2025 won't be in the future. Right now we're in 2022. So anyways, but that's what we're going to do currently. And as soon as we catch up to this date, then we'll, I'll tell you kind of maybe how to adjust it, but we'll stick with that date for now. That's in there. And so, we've got our, journal entry format here, right? We got our debits and credits. We've got our accounts that we've got to enter first. So we're just going to follow that format that we have laid out in there. The first one that we're going to do is going to be a loan. So we're going to take out a loan, and that's going to be for several things. We're going to do, it's going to be fixed asset computers will be one of them. The next one down is going to be fixed asset computers again, just another fixed asset computer, another computer there. We're going to have furniture, and we are going to do another furniture. So these are things we're buying. It's actually with a loan that we're going to have here, and it's going to be computer supplies. And all of these, so those are all going to be debits. The credit here is going to be our notes payable via our systems, okay? So our debits, as we go down here, we're going to have 9,000 there, 3,000 for that computer, 1,024, 2,000, or 1,276. There we go. And 700. Okay, so as we go on this, we can tell kind of our offsetting, right? So we can see at the bottom if our journal entry is balanced. And so on this one, of course, to balance it out, it's going to have to be 15,000, which matches up with what we have in our book. So we're going to have a bunch of descriptions for this. And so we're going to go ahead and enter those descriptions here. As we put this in, we're actually going to be putting in a new, it looks like a new vendor here. So it's going to be VR Systems Inc. is going to be that. It won't be a client. The clients are customers, right? And it's not going to be an employee, so this will be a vendor. So we need to make sure to set it as vendor as we do that, just to get that in there. And then we'll go ahead and save it. Okay, so now that'll be in there for us to pull up for the rest of these here. There we go. So that is our journal entry for the very first journal entry, and then we can go ahead and hit save and new. This green box down here, you either have the option of doing save and close or save and new. We're going to do the next journal entry, so we'll go ahead and do save and new, and it'll bring up a blank journal entry form for us, having saved that one, right? To look back at the old journal entries, if you do make a mistake and you realize you've made a mistake on a journal entry, you can go back and fix it. And so a good way to find those is when you're in here, you can open up the journal entry the window for journal entries, like you're gonna enter a new one. Go up to the top left here, and this little kind of time clock arrow is going to show you the history. So this is the history. So we can, if we want to, go back to that one that we just did. See, there it is. And so we're able to look at that and edit it and save it again if we need to.